This is Common Core State Standard Support Video in Mathematics. The standard we are addressing now is 7.G.A.2. This standard states draw freehand with ruler and protractor and with technology geometric shapes with given conditions. Focus on constructing triangles from three measures of angles or sides, noticing when the conditions determine a unique triangle, more than one triangle, or no triangle. First, let's see what other standards are related to 7.G.A.2. Back in fourth grade, there was standard 4MDC5A that gave students exposure to angles and angle measure. This fourth grade standard states an angle is measured with reference to a circle with its center at the common endpoint of the rays by considering the fraction of the circular arc between the points where the two rays intersect the circle. Also in fourth grade, a related standard was 4MDC6 that talked about actually measuring angles in whole number degrees using a protractor. Also in fourth grade, there is standard 4GA1 that talks about drawing points, lines, line segments, rays, and angles. And notice that they do introduce the classifications of angles based on measure, those being right, acute, and obtuse angles. This should in turn help students identify triangles based on angle measures. So that would give them some background and a little bit of experience with the terms that would lead to right triangle, acute triangle, and obtuse triangle. Note that this is the only Common Core standard where the term obtuse is mentioned. Also, the term acute only appears again at the high school level with regard to trigonometry. Another standard in fourth grade, this one is 4GA2. This one talks about classifying two-dimensional figures based on the presence or absence of parallel or perpendicular lines, or the presence or absence of angles of a specific size. Notice the last statement, recognize right triangles as a category and identify right triangles. So at the fourth grade level, they've already been exposed to the idea of a right triangle. Notice that when addressing standard 7GA2, that seems like an appropriate time to classify triangles based on angle measure. In seventh grade, there's a related standard, 7GB, that talks about supplementary angles, which leads to the idea of the sum of the angles of a triangle being 180. This seventh grade standard will help set the foundation for standard 8GA2, which talks about two-dimensional figures being congruent to one another. Notice that this eighth grade standard is the first mention of the concept of congruency in the Common Core standards. In eighth grade, we have this other standard, 8GA5, that talks about using informal arguments to establish facts about the angle sum of triangles. If we switch our focus a little bit to the idea of constructing triangles from measures of sides versus angles, there is this high school standard, HSGCOC10, that talks about proving theorems about triangles. And that includes measures of interior angles of a triangle sum being 180 and the base angles of isosceles triangles being congruent. Notice that this high school standard is the only standard where the term isosceles appears. Also, the term scalene is not mentioned anywhere in the standards. And the term equilateral does not occur until the high school geometry standards. So it seems like there's not much of a focus in, as far as the terminology when it comes to the classification of triangles based on the sides. Since this isn't really addressed in the standards, you know, this standard 7GA2 seems like an appropriate time to classify triangles based on the lengths of the sides. In looking at the standard and these last statements dealing with the conditions that determine different contexts as far as the number of triangles. If we look at the idea of having more than one triangle formed, there is standard 8GA4. that talks about the similarity of figures. So this standard here, 7.G.A.2, can help lay the foundation for the idea of similar figures. That'll come up in eighth grade. Again, this standard in eighth grade is the first formal mention of the concept of similarity in the mathematics content standards. But again, we can use this seventh grade standard to start laying the foundation for that, whether or not we use the actual mathematical terminology. Teachers should be able to find some type of software that can actually be used to measure angles. And that's what we have here in this case. We have a protractor that we can use to measure angles. And so this is a very useful tool that, again, we can use. Let's start by focusing on constructing triangles from three measures of angles. Let's say our task was to construct a triangle with angle measures 34, 71, and 75 degrees. Well, let's take our ruler and let's draw a segment. And let's start off by measuring off a 34 degree angle. So we take our protractor and we do that. And so we use our ruler to mark off that segment so that we have this ray. This is the beginning foundation for our triangle. So far we have our one angle of 34 degrees. Now let's construct a 71 degree angle from this other vertex. Well, right now it's just the end point, but it will be the vertex of our triangle. Okay, we have a little bit of a problem here. The way that the protractor is set up, I can measure the 71 degrees here, but I need the angle measure over here. So what am I going to do? Well, here's a little trick. Notice that if we get the supplement of 71 degrees, that's 109. So that's a little trick that we can use. We can use the measure of 109 degrees over here, and the supplement will be 71 degrees over here on the left-hand side. So that's what we can do. We can use this little trick of using the supplement of an angle to get the angle that we want. So let's put our protractor in the proper location, and we'll measure off 109 degrees instead to get the 71 degree angle that we want as part of our triangle. So now we would use our ruler and draw our segment. Let's get that out of the way, and let's worry about now the 75 degree angle. Well, we've already got our triangle formed, so let's see what the angle measure is for this third angle up at the top. So we take our protractor, put it in position. Look at our measurement. And yes, it is 75 degrees. So we're in business. We're set. So now we have our third angle being 75 degrees. Let's knock off the extra part of the segments. And there we have it. We've constructed our triangle with measures 34, 71, and 75 degrees. Since we didn't have any directions as far as how long or short to make the sides of this triangle, then students are going to come up with different size triangles. They'll all have the correct measurements, 34, 71, and 75 degrees, but they will be different sizes. So this sets up this idea of these triangles being similar. So in fact, if you look at this in terms of the actual sides, we will have more than one triangle formed. So this might be an example here of what some of the different triangles that students come up with would look like. Now, we can use this and link it to standard 8GA4. But what we can also do is link this to standard 8GA5 and use it to discover or informally prove that the sum of the interior angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. So this is what we can do to do that. Pick out three different size triangles, but all of them have the same 3-degree measures. So let's place one triangle like this. Then let's take another one and invert it over and fit it like this. And then we'll take our third triangle and place it like this. Now notice the three different angles here that come from three different triangles. We have our 71, our 75, and our 34. And if you add them up, that is 180 degrees, and that is our straight angle here. If we double check the sum, yep, it's 180. Now, the standard talks about constructing triangles from three measures of angles. But we can throw the students a little bit of a curve. What if we ask them to construct a triangle with angle measures 22 and 136? We've only given them two angle measures. Well, let's see what happens. Let's draw a segment as our starting point. We'll take our protractor and let's start off measuring the angle that's 136 degrees. So we do that, take our segment, and so we have our angle. And now let's pick this endpoint over here. And well, we couldn't measure the angle 22 directly, but what we can do is get the supplement 158, which will give us the 22 degrees here that we're looking for. So we do that, and let's draw it. And so we're almost set, except we need to extend this other segment a little bit. There you go. Now the question is, well, that third angle in this triangle, what is the measure for that one? If we take our protractor and measure it, look what happens. It's 22 degrees. Let's check our figures. If we combine 22 and 22 and 136, that is 180. And again, since students didn't have any specific lengths for the sides, they will end up making more than one triangle out of it. They're going to have, you know, similar triangles. So again, you know, this might be an example of what they come up with, but they're all going to look exactly alike, even though the lengths of the sides might be different sizes. Let's take yet another example. Let's say you give them this task: construct a triangle with angle measures 93, 64, and 43. Okay, just like before, we had a little bit of a problem. I want my 93 degree angle on the left, not on the right. So let's use our little trick where we can use the supplement of it. And let's reverse it. So we've got the 87 degree angle over here, which will give us the 93 degree angle that we're looking for. So let's do that. So we have our 93 degree angle. Let's go ahead and go with the 43 degree angle that we need and use this endpoint on the left, because it'll be a lot easier to measure the angle that way. So here we go, extend your segment. So we have our 43 degree and our 93 degree angles. So now the question is, the 64 degrees, is that going to be that top angle? Well, let's measure it. Okay, wait a minute, we got a problem. That's not 64 degrees. The protractor is saying 44 degrees. Well, it turns out this isn't possible. There's no way that we can do this. There's no triangle that can be formed with these three angles. And of course, what students can do is verify whether or not those three angles that were given add up to be 180 degrees. And of course, they'll find out no. So given similar tasks where the sum of the three angles is not 180 degrees, students will discover that no triangle is possible. So far, students have constructed triangles based on information regarding angle measure. The results included acute, right, and obtuse triangles. Students should note that when only given information about angle measures, the constructed triangles were similar, even though no information was provided regarding side lengths. And students should also realize that the sum of the three interior angles of a triangle must be 180 degrees.